दोस्तों, इस क्लास में आपको मैं डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड करूंगा उसी मैटर की जो पिछली क्लास में मैंने आपको 80 WPM पर प्रोवाइड किया है। 1000 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन है और इस क्लास में स्पीड होगी 100 WPM। डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूं, बी रेडी फॉर इट। ए लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ देयर लाइव्स इज स्पेंट इन स्ट्रगलिंग फॉर वाटर, देयरफॉर दिस गवर्नमेंट हैज डिसाइडेड टू एम्फेसाइज अपॉन ए स्पेशल टास्क एंड दैट इज How to ensure availability of water in every house? How does every house get water? Pure drinking water. And so I declare from the Red Fort today that in the days to come, we will take forward the Jal Jeevan Mission. The central and the state governments will jointly work on this Jal Jeevan Mission. We have promised to spend more than ₹3.5 lakh crores on this mission in the coming years. Work should be done on water conservation, irrigation, rainwater harvesting, seawater or wastewater treatment, and per drop more crop micro irrigation for the farmers. Water conservation campaigns should be launched, creating awareness in the common citizens about water, arousing their sensitivity so that they understand the importance of water. Even the children should be taught about water conservation as part of their curriculum in their childhood. We must move forward with the belief that in the next 5 years, we have to do more than 4 times the work that has been done in the last 70 years for water conservation and to revive the sources of water. We cannot wait any longer. Approximately 100 years ago, there lived a Jan Saint who was born in a farmer's family. He used to work in the fields, but under the influence of Jainism, he became a Jan Saint called Buddhi Sagar Ji Maharaj. He left behind some scriptures 100 years ago in which he shared a premonition that there will be a time when water will be sold in grocery shops. Can you imagine that the words of the saint written 100 years ago have actually become a reality now? What was predicted a century ago is now a ground reality, and today we all are actually buying water from grocery shops. Dear countrymen, our nation has reached a phase when we should be transparent about everything. Time has now come that we should take challenges head on. Sometimes decisions are taken keeping in mind political advantage, but they come at the cost of growth of future generation of our country. I would like to highlight the issue of population explosion in one country from the ages of the Red Fort today. I would like all the people of our society to watch their lives closely and see how much they have served their families by limiting increase in family size. It is about how the family has moved forward in just a generation or two, how the children have got education, how the family is free from disease, how well the family fulfills their primary needs. We should learn from them. Before a child arrives into our family, we should think, have I prepared myself to fulfill the needs of the child? Or will I leave it dependent on the society? Will I leave the child unnurtured? no parents can continue to give birth to children who are forced to live this type of life, and therefore a social awareness is needed. The people who have played this huge role need to be honored, and by setting them as examples, we need to inspire the segment of the society who are still not thinking on these lines. We need to worry about population explosion. Governments also have to come forward through different schemes. Be it the state government or the central government, everyone has to work together to shoulder this responsibility. We cannot think of an unhealthy society. We cannot think of an uneducated society. In 21st century India, the ability to fulfill dreams starts with a person, starts with a family. If the population is not educated, not healthy, then neither the home nor the country can be happy. If the population is educated, empowered and skilled, and has adequate means available to achieve the right ambience to fulfill their wishes and needs, then I think the country can fulfill these things. You are well aware that corruption and nepotism have damaged our country beyond imagination and entered into our lives like termites. We are continuously trying to weed them out. There have been successes also, but the disease is so deeply entrenched, the disease is so widespread that we will have to keep putting in more efforts, and that too at every level, not just at the government level, and we need to keep doing it continuously. All work cannot be done at one go. Bad habits are like chronic disease. Sometimes it gets cured, but sometimes it relapses. This too is a disease for which we have taken many steps, eliminating it by continuous use of technology. Every effort has been made to strengthen honesty and transparency at all levels. You must have seen that immediately after formation of the government, and also in the last 5 years, the government has removed many top officials. All such people creating obstacles were told that the country does not need their services anymore, and they have been removed. Brothers and sisters, the country has, in a way, matured after so many years of independence. We are going to celebrate the 75th anniversary of independence. This freedom is as precious to us as our ethical values, attitudes and sensitivities. Whenever I hold meetings with officials, I would always mention, I do not talk about it publicly, but today I feel like speaking out. I repeatedly exhort the officials that after so many years of independence, can we not do something about cutting down red tape and reduce the involvement of the government in the daily life of the common man? The meaning of an independent India for me is to create an ecosystem that gradually reduces the involvement of government in the lives of its peoples. This will give people the choice to decide about their own destiny and embark upon whichever direction they wish in the national interest, for betterment of their families, and in the pursuit of their dreams. दोस्तों इसी के साथ ये डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है. मुझे उम्मीद है आप लोगों ने बहुत अच्छे से इस मैटर को लिखा होगा. 80 WPM पर भी मैंने इसकी डिक्टेशन आपको प्रोवाइड की हुई है पिछली वीडियो में. तो अगर आपको इसको लिखने में कुछ भी अगर प्रॉब्लम होती है तो पहले आप 80 WPM को अच्छे से लिखें, उसके बाद इसकी प्रैक्टिस करें ताकि इस तरीके के मैटर्स लिखने की आपकी हैबिट बन जाए और एग्ज़ाम में आपको प्रॉब्लम न हो. सो आपसे मैं मुलाकात करूँगा अगली क्लास में अगली ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय, टेक केयर.